Power of Om and Uma. Uma is the power of Reiki, which is the consort of Shankar, the benevolent form of Shiv, and Om is the power of Durga, which is the Ichha Shakti. If you reverse the Om, it becomes Uma. That's why you call Uma Shankar. Right? Power of Mother Mary, it becomes, which begets the Christ, is the power of Reiki, power of love. Reiki is just a name that was given, right? Eventually you can give it any name, but it is power of grace. And Christ comes out of the power of grace, and then one who is born out of that power of grace is called the Son of God, right? Isa. Okay. The Holy Ghost is the Param Shakti. Okay. When you experience the vibrations in your body, some of you might feel the tingling in the palms when the energy descends, that's the Holy Ghost. When you feel that mysterious feeling while you're doing the Reiki healing, and a feeling that kind of uplifts you, almost like an intoxication, that's the feeling of Radha or the Mother Mary. That's how Radha was feeling, right? To multiply that joy. Because Radha was in that state throughout, we just go for 30 minutes of healing and then we have to pay our credit card bills, right? But if we can stay in that state for a prolonged period of time, we become Radha.
And eventually be able to pay the credit cards and then being in that state. Don't have to come out of it and then becomes a lifestyle.
Okay, so therefore there is a combination of Shakti and Bhakti that's required. Right? If you are completely into Bhakti, a lot of love, but you may not have money to pay your credit cards. If you're completely a worshipper of Shakti, you might become like Hitler. But there's no love, but constantly doing things. Therefore, balance is a combination of Shakti and Bhakti. And that's what we practice. Okay? Through the Kriya Yoga techniques, we develop the Shakti, the Ichha Shakti. Through breath-based techniques and through mental focus-based techniques. Okay? Through Reiki techniques of surrender, we inject bhakti, love, the nectar of love in each point in our body and make it more loving. Right? It's like magnetism working. Okay? So the parashakti, the power of Reiki, enters our crown chakra, okay, through a pillar of light called Antahkaran, which is also called our conscience. Right? People know what conscience is, sometimes people forget. Because as kids we remember, we used to hear the voice of conscience, then as you become adult, the conscience keeps speaking, I gotta just get my good rating at work. So Antahkaran is your conscience, the pillar of conscience. Okay? Enters at the crown and goes to your body. That's how Parashakti enters. Okay? In a normal human being, that Parashakti, the column of Parashakti is like the tip of a pencil. During the initiation process that we learn from our master, that Antahkaran is expanded. Automatically when the pipe is expanded, more water is going to flow, so more Parashakti starts descending on us. Okay, it's like a dial-up connection versus cable modem versus fibers. Okay. And then Param Shakti enters through our medulla oblongata, right, the mouth of God, at the base of the head. That's why all the devtas have a big halo, because their back thada chakra is expanded. It goes inside, and within the Antahkaran there is a channel called the Shushmana. It's a channel. Okay, it goes inside and then it gets mixed up. It's called the prana. Somebody hits you here, you will die. So the pranic shakti enters here, becomes the kundalini shakti. And the para shakti enters from here, becomes the reiki power. So we have to expand both the channels. During the initiation process, we expand the Antahkaran, we also expand the channel through which param shakti enters, the pranic shakti enters. And then during the initiation process, the guru or the master creates a copy of all his knowledge. So this is what the yogis found. This was a discovery, right? So we have disc copy, DVD copies, right? Some people download torrents, but getting knowledge from different places. That's the same concept. So the yogis realize that, yeah, after 100 years of practice, I have a way in which I can create a copy of my intellect, my aura, into someone. And that boosts their evolution. So if somebody has lived for 100 years, they acquired all the knowledge, then the student lived for another 50, 60 years, acquired knowledge 160 years, then their student lived for another 100 years, 260 years, that knowledge keeps getting transferred throughout the lineage. By the time it travels 5,000, 6,000, millions of years, you can imagine how much buildup of knowledge there is, store of the knowledge. And then through the initiation process, you just create a copy of that knowledge and then initiate. Very simple process. Now, does the initiate become realized all of a sudden? No. It could still happen if the initiate is completely receptive. But the thing is that knowledge is made accessible to you, but in a similar way as if you put 200 watts of power and 100 watts of bulb, it'll blow up. So our mind is not ready. So over years of time, that knowledge gradually percolates to. Even when you give up your practice, even you just shake hands with the yogi, right? Shake hands with the realized master. Over years of practice, that knowledge, or years of just living, that knowledge will gradually start coming to your mind. Sometimes you think, where did this thought come from?
Mm.
But it's gradually seeping in through the ego. Ego, glad, you know, you should be glad ego is a little porous. The more solid the ego is, of course, harder it is, but eventually that power of love, power of divine will breaks through the ego and keeps percolating, keeps absorbing in our aura, in our mind. So our thought patterns change over years. We start realizing, well, this is something I never used to do it right, so I need to correct myself, or I used to overthink. Okay, realizations start coming in. And then one day the final realization comes. All the initiate can do is, if you practice more, that process, that absorption happens sooner. If you practice less, it takes time. But as long as you are receptive, because you have been initiated, that process continues life after life. Some people you see, you meet them, they don't follow any spiritual practices, but they have a lot of knowledge through their direct realization. Or they have an interest towards spirituality. How is that happening versus somebody else who just wants to make money? So then they have gone through some sort of a process in their past lives, right, that has brought them to that level. Okay. So once that process is triggered, it never, never, never stops. Because truth always, always finds a place in your aura, starts expanding. So that's the power of initiation.